write down. Next is specific heat capacity of the gases. Okay. Since we are going to deal with gas as our system going forward, so we must be knowing, in detail about how specific heat of gases are and how to deal with the gases. So that is why this topic, okay? Now, when it comes to gases, we have already learned in the thermal properties of matter that gas can have two kinds of specific heat, isn't it? Specific heat at constant volume and specific heat at constant pressure. Okay. Now, when I say only specific heat, when I only say the specific heat, I mean to say per kg. So CV will be equal to 1 by mass into delta Q by delta T at constant volume. But specific heat has little meaning, or it is not so useful when it comes to gases. So what we define is molar specific heat. Okay, molar specific heat when I just say specific heat, I mean to say the specific with respect to mass. But when I specify that it is molar, then I need to take molar specific heat, which is per mole. So 1 by n delta Q by delta T at constant volume, right? So delta Q at constant volume should be equal to n CV delta T, okay? And at constant pressure, delta Q at constant pressure will be equal to similarly n cp delta t. Okay, and there are so many other specific heats possible, but as we have learned earlier also, only two standard types of specific heats are there. Okay, now why we are doing this topic again, as we have done already, is to find out a relation between molar specific heat at constant volume and molar specific heat at constant pressure. Okay, so suppose this is the relation I am talking about, delta Q is equal to delta U plus work done. Okay, now tell me, if the change in temperature is delta T between the two states of the gas, if change in temperature is delta T for constant volume process, for constant volume process, okay, you need to basically apply this equation. Okay, so things which are given to you are, let's say, CP is given, CV is given, molar specific heats are given to you, and the pressure is also given to you. Okay, now can you find out what is when you substitute, how does equation transform? All of you, please do it. How much will be the W?
Zero.
Work done will be zero. All of you agree this? Work done is integral of PdV, and it is constant volume. So change in volume is zero. dV is zero all the time. So that is why the work done is zero. Okay, and delta Q is how much at constant volume? We can get that from the definition of molar specific heat, right? Since it is a constant volume which is going on, I can say delta Q is equal to n CV delta T. Okay, so if I substitute these values there, I'll get n CV delta T is equal to delta U plus zero. So I'm getting delta U is equal to NCV delta T. Now we have derived this expression of change in internal energy for constant volume. Okay. Now suppose the change in temperature is delta T and the process is not constant volume, it is some other process. But delta T is a change in temperature. Can I still say that change in internal energy should be this? Or then I have to derive it again for that process?
It will be same.
Reason?
Sir, internal energy only depends on temperature of the system or change in temperature.
See, change in internal energy does not depend on what process you are following. Okay. It only depends on initial location and final location. And luckily, you have found out change in internal energy for a particular kind of process. Okay. Even though you have found out for a particular type of process, change in internal energy, but since change in internal energy does not depend on what process it is, you're going to get the same expression of the change in internal energy for whatever process you assume, because it doesn't depend on what process you're following, what path you're following. It only depends on initial point and the final point. Okay. And hence, please write down for ideal gases, delta U is equal to NCV delta T for all processes. It does not matter what process you are following. Okay. It could be constant pressure, constant volume, constant temperature. It does not matter. Change in internal energy will be this. If delta T is a change in temperature, delta U is equal to NCV delta T. Okay. So this is a very powerful equation, as you can use it anywhere. Okay. Now I'm going to apply delta Q is equal to delta U plus W for constant pressure. Okay. Again, things that are given to you, Cp, Cv, delta T, pressure, and you can say delta V also if you want to. Now substitute the values over there for constant pressure. Okay, so here it is. At constant pressure, delta Q at constant pressure will be equal to Cp delta T, right? And I know that delta U, does not matter what is the process, will be always NCV delta T. And work done should be equal to pressure into delta V, because it is basically integral of PdV. Since pressure is constant at constant pressure, so P comes out of integral. It is simply P integral dV, which is P into delta V only. Okay. So I can substitute the values over there. I'll get NCP delta T NCP delta T is equal to NCV delta T plus P delta V. Okay. Now I can further simplify this, because I have a state equation PV is equal to NRT. So from here, since pressure is constant, P delta V will be equal to NR delta T. So I can substitute P delta V over there, and then I'll get this NCP delta T is equal to NCV delta T plus NR delta T. Okay. So from here, I will get Cp minus Cv is equal to R, gas constant R. Okay. Do you know the value of capital R? R is equal to what?
8.314
SI units. Okay. In chemistry, you're dealing with liters. So So that is why the unit is different, and hence the value is different in chemistry. In chemistry, you might be using 0.0814. Anyways, now since we have started talking about the processes, as in what does process means? Process means that suppose the state of the system is one, initial state is one and the final state is two. What process or what path the system is taking to go from initial position to the final position? Okay, that is called a thermodynamic process. Okay, but we will discuss that a little later. Right now we are going to discuss a couple of more basic things. The first is equilibrium state. Please write down. So please write down the definition of equilibrium state. It is the state which is completely described by the specific values of some macro variables. Now, what do you mean by macro variable? Macro variable could be pressure, volume, temperature, density, mass, internal energy. So these all are macro variables. So if I'm able to describe what is going on with the system completely by using these macro variables, then the system is in equilibrium. But what happens is sometimes system is not in equilibrium. For example, there is this room, okay? Inside this room, you light up a fire over here. There is, let us say, fire. Okay, over here there is a fire and you're saying that my entire system is the room. The complete room is my system. So this is your system boundary. Okay. Will the temperature over this zone be same as temperature over that zone? Will it be same? Ronak, temperature near the fire, will it be same as temperature at the corner of the room? No, right? So temperature will be different at different locations of the room. Ahriman, why do you think it is same temperature? So when you light up the gas, the temperature near the gas is same as throughout the kitchen. Then everything inside the kitchen will cook, na? So temperature at different points in the room are different. Okay, and since temperatures are different, how can you describe the temperature of the system? What do you call temperature system? Temperature of this location, that location, this one, this one, this one. You cannot describe the temperature of your system because at different locations, different temperature is there. That is why this system is not in equilibrium. Okay. Because you cannot describe the temperature of the system. Although you can probably describe the volume of the system, but pressure is different at different locations. Densities will be different. Okay. And internal energy will be different at different locations. So that is the reason why, but then if you talk about the total internal energy, that will be same. So pressure, temperature, and density, these three things are different at different points on the system. So you cannot describe the, temperature of the system because at different location, different temperature is there. And hence this is not in equilibrium. So I cannot study the system because I'm not able to define what is the system's temperature, system's pressure, system's density. Okay, and hence for a system, it is very essential that it should be in equilibrium to study it. Otherwise, you don't know what is temperature, you don't know what is pressure, you don't know what is density. Okay, so there are a few examples of non-equilibrium states in our textbook. For example, if this happens, there is a, let's say, piston. Okay, this side is gas and this side is vacuum. You're holding this piston right now and then you release the piston. What will happen to this piston? Will it move this way very quickly?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
It will move quickly that side. Now, when it is moving quickly that side, let us say after some milliseconds, the piston reaches at the end. The distribution in the gas molecule will be something like this. It will be still dense over here. The molecules will be dense over here, but the few molecules will be here. So you can see that pressure over here is higher than pressure over there. I'm talking about immediate, okay? As soon as the piston moves a little bit, you are drawing the pressure, or you're drawing where the gas molecules are. So pressure over here is different from pressure over there. So that is the reason why this is not in equilibrium. But if you leave the system for a very long time, then pressure will even out. Then it will come in equilibrium. But right now, you cannot define what is the pressure of the system. Fine. Now, similarly, another example is explosion. Okay, so when explosion happens, let's say there is a bomb and explosion happens. Okay, so the temperature at different points will be different. Even the pressure is different at different points. Because of that, you can't even measure, or you can't define a system properly if the thing which is under observation or which you are studying, if that is not in equilibrium, you cannot find out its pressure, its temperature, its density, so many other variables you cannot find out, so you cannot study it. Okay, so hence our focus is only those systems which are in equilibrium. Okay, otherwise you can't define the system itself properly. Right, so this is called the equilibrium state.